That's, yeah, sustain, you know what we should be aware? It's not true that simply by doing nothing you support the system. Because often what people think is doing nothing is that they are doing quite many things. The system needs us to reproduce itself. We are all the time active and so on. That's what fascinates me. This how, if you, how should I put it, what fascinates me is how even when we think we are doing nothing by, okay, we think we are doing nothing, but we are doing nothing in the mode of our cynical but cynical doubt. But even then, we are usually active. You probably know my old joke from my parallax view, I use it there, but it's a wonderful one, I will repeat it, about that Niels Bohr who was visited in his country house by a scientist friend, and the friend saw above the entrance to his wooden house horseshoe, which I don't know if it is here in Europe. A horseshoe above the entrance is a superstitious item which allegedly prevents evil spirits to enter the house. So a friend asked Niels Bohr, but are you crazy? Are you superstitious? Why do you have this there? Niels Bohr answered, of course I'm not superstitious. Then the friend asked him, but why do you have it? Niels Bohr answered, I have it, I don't believe it, but I have it there because I was told that it works, horseshoe, even if you don't believe in it. That's how ideology functions today. You don't believe in it, you think you are cynical, but you participate in it somehow. And that's the different, that's the difficult thing to do. So, no, I only, and obviously many leftists were very hurt by this, because not only Critchley, the animosity exploded everywhere, how should I put it, no. Why? Because I touched their sacred cow. They really think that their protests are something tremendous. That, I mean, I'm here, I know that, you know what was a sobering effect? I know that it was meant as a bad, stupid joke, that it's not true. But I liked it in a masochist way, almost, after the big anti-Iraq war protests in London. Bush visited United Kingdom, and the journalist asked him, what does he think about big 1 million people on Trafalgar Square demonstrations against? You know what was President Bush's answer? Very cynical, stupid, but unfortunately I think there is an element of truth in it. It was, I totally support and admire these demonstrations. And then he said, you see, this is why we are going to Iraq, so that people there will also be able to demonstrate like people. I mean, it may be cynical, but you know, what disturbed me a little bit, I was participant in many demonstrations at that point, but what disturbed me a little bit is how, at the end of the day, everybody was satisfied. Those in power were satisfied, you see, we are a democratic society, they can protest, because they knew that it will not affect in any way the decision, will there be a war or not. The protesters were satisfied, I claim, a little bit cynically, because most of them knew that this is a gesture of protest which will not change anything. So it surprised me how, at the end of the day, it's as if everybody did his or her duty, everybody was satisfied, and so on. I claim there are often situations where you are, I think, we are wrong when we think that the strategy of those in power is to keep you inactive. No, they want dialogue, contact, and so on. Their strategy is, as my friend Robert Faller, the Austrian philosopher who invented the notion of interpassivity, said, their strategy is the one that in boxing, I think, you call it clinching to the enemy. You know, like, please come, let us have dialogue, and so on and so on. In such a situation, ominous silence is much better. I remember from my own socialist youth, where I'm not saying I was a great dissident, but somehow part of it, and incidentally, I felt absolutely at home, as if the Republican Convention was back into real socialism. Why? You notice how Republicans repeat all the time, we are for change, for radical change, and so on. But they are the guys who are in power all the time. And I remember when I was young, and we started a little bit dissidents here and there, the answer of communists were not, we are status quo, don't do it. Their answer was, you are not critical enough. We communists are agents of radical change. You know, like, you had the same paradox of a power structure which legitimized itself as an agent of a permanent radical change, and so on and so on. So I feel very much at home with this stuff. With this topic here, no? But, okay, sorry, I was too long. Okay, but you got the idea, but no, that's not my I think one should be simply not unprincipled, but principled opportunist here. Let's do everything. Big protests when big protests are needed. Violence when violence is needed. Only civil disobedience when that is needed. Doing nothing when that works. And I remember, back to my socialist experience, at some point when nomenclatura in power started to lose their confidence, they terribly wanted dialogue with us. We got all the time calls come to us to Central Committee, let's have a debate. And then when once we went there, we spit on them, you are worse than Stalin. And we thought we would be maybe arrested a little bit. No danger, but so that you can then have your badge of honor, victim of communism. And no, communists told us so nice that you can, let's debate more and so on and so on. And then next time, we did nothing. We didn't come. And this incredibly raised the temperature, you know, like, my God, no dialogue, what is... At certain point, this works, non-activity. Just doing, you know, when you are expected to do something, doing nothing can create terrible anxiety, which is good. It puts fear into them in power.